In the early 1900s, there was this big idea in mathematics that one should really formalize everything and have a very solid foundation and axioms, and everything should follow from those axioms. And people really did work on this, so they tried to come up with just the right formal system, the right axioms and so on, that could prove all these true things we know. But then they kept running into problems. So they found some inconsistencies in their systems and so on. And eventually, a mathematician called Hilbert in the 1920s started this big program. So he thought that what mathematics really needs is a formal foundation, an axiomatic system, and then also a proof that that's the right system somehow. I'm being rather vague here, but I think you get the idea. So you just want mathematics to be really solid, and there should be nothing wrong with it, and it should have a very solid foundation. And we should know that it has a very solid foundation, so we should be able to prove that the foundation is solid. And Hilbert was working on this and convinced other people to think about this. But then one day, another mathematician called Gödel came along and destroyed this entire idea with his result. And this result is known as Gödel's Incompleteness Theorem. Actually, it's not just one theorem. It's two theorems, and there are different versions of them. You can formulate them in slightly different ways. But what I want to do here is to just tell you the general idea and then give you a sketch of a proof for Gödel's first incompleteness theorem. This is not going to be super formal, but I want to give you the main idea. And the reason for this is that it actually has some connections with computability. Okay, so here's some version of Gödel's first incompleteness theorem. It states that no sufficiently powerful formal system is both sound and complete. So what do these things mean? A formal system is a formal language in which we can make statements, and a set of rules of inference, which allow us to derive new statements from given ones. The system also has a finite set of axioms. So axioms are statements we consider to be true. To prove a statement in a formal system, we repeatedly apply the rules of inference in such a way that the statement is derived from the axioms. So this is really just how mathematics works, right? We make some basic assumption of things that are true. Those are the axioms. And then we have certain formal rules that we can apply to derive new statements from those axioms. What does sound mean? A formal system is sound if only true statements have a proof. And what is complete? A formal system is complete if all true statements have a proof. So in a system that is sound and complete, we can prove all true statements and only true statements. We can prove all true statements because of completeness, and we can prove only true statements because of soundness. So a statement is true if and only if it has a proof. Now, this seems like a nice property to have. I mean, in some sense, this is exactly what you would expect. And this is really what Hilbert wanted. But Gödel says this cannot exist. So if you have a system that is sufficiently powerful, then it cannot be both sound and complete. You either can have a sound system, but then it won't be complete, or you can have a complete system, but then it won't be sound. I wasn't around at the time, but I assume this was a big shock to Hilbert and other mathematicians at the time, because it basically meant that it's impossible to come up with this perfect, beautiful foundation for mathematics. There will always be certain things lacking or things being inconsistent. It's very disappointing. But it also fascinating and makes things really quite interesting. So the proof of Gödel's incompleteness theorem, if you do it formally, is probably quite involved, but we can give a short sketch here that should convince you that this theorem is true, and we will use the fact that we know that the halting problem is not decidable. The idea is the following. Suppose we have a system that is powerful enough to express statements of the form Turing machine M halts on input X. Now, assume that this system is also sound and complete. So we have proofs for all true statements and only for true statements. Then we could also solve the halting problem. And here's a program that would achieve this. We enumerate all bit strings. And for each bit string, we check whether this bit string happens to encode a valid proof for the statement M halts on X. If we find a bit string that is indeed a proof for this statement, then we return 1. We say yes, we believe M halts on X. On the other hand, if we encounter a bit string that we can check is a valid proof for M does not halt on X, then we return 0. We say no, M does not halt on X. This is the entire program. I claim this program would solve the halting problem. So first of all, every step in this program can be actually executed. We've discussed before that there are systems where you can write statements in a formal language and you give it a proof and the computer checks automatically whether this proof is really a valid proof for the statement. Such systems exist, so this is not at all a problem. And everything else in this program is trivial. Now, I also claim that this program always terminates. This is because either M halts on X or M does not halt on X. So one of these two statements is certainly true. And because our system is complete, all true statements have a proof. So one of these two statements has a valid proof. And we enumerate all potential proofs, all bit strings. So eventually we will find one that proves one of those two statements and the program will terminate. So this always terminates, so it does compute something. And it also computes the halting problem because we have soundness, so when we return yes or 1, then it really means that the statement M halts on X has a proof and therefore is true. That's what soundness means. If something has a proof, it must be true. And if we return 0 or no, then M does indeed not halt on X because that is a statement that has a proof and therefore the statement has to be true. So this program solves the halting problem, but we know that the halting problem cannot be solved, and therefore some of our assumptions must be wrong, and the assumption that we made was that we have a sufficiently powerful formal system that is sound and complete. So this cannot exist.